Hi everyone, my name is MadMatt Lugos and welcome back to Gris. So last time we finished making our way through the red part of the game. We're now in the green part of the game where nature has taken over a bit. The roots and the branches started sprouting throughout the world, and we made our way down into the more jungle-like area where we met our friend Mr. Cuboid, who we've been feeding lots of cuboid-shaped apples. He's dug his way underground here through the bottom of the tree, and we're going to carry on things now. Let's go, Mr. Cuboid. This guy's adorable. He's probably the only character you're going to run into with a bigger forehead than me. I mean, look at that thing. Oh, you keep eating things, buddy. Right, can we jump up onto these pipes?
Yep.
Come on, that's it. Thank you, friend. You can communicate with the forest. I'll be on the lookout for more apples for you, friend. He can't make that jump. Okay, might not have needed to do it. Maybe I didn't need to do that, but. Oh, yeah, he couldn't get through. What? How did you get up there? I have no idea how we got up there. This is one magical cuboid. Oh, it's nice having a friend in the world here. Get yourself an apple, friend. Hey! You gotta love Mr. Cuboid. Where did he go? Oh, he's in front of me. Careful, friend. Hey! Oh no! You alright? Take it easy, Mr. Cuboid. We don't want to hurt ourselves. Alright. We got a Steam achievement for that. What's up? I hope nothing happens to Mr. Cuboid. Is he gone? Come back, Mr. Cuboid. Alright. See you later, Mr. Cuboid. It was fun. New ability here, so we need two more spirits. Let's head right first. Hey, mushroom. Lots of friends here. Oh, it was a trick. A trick of friendship. Hello. Hello. Hello, Mr. Four Eyes. Hiya. Hi, Mr. Triangle Head. Hello. Hello, Mrs. Four Eyes. Hey, Mushroom Head. Hey guys. Hey, it's the Cuboid. Thanks, Mr. Cuboid. Very grateful. Let's go find the other spirit. Nice help from lovely Mr. Cuboid and his family. Huh. I can't see the other spirit anywhere. Don't think we can jump between these squares either. Maybe we need some sort of double jump. I get it. You have to jump into nothingness. Mm-hmm. go. Damn. Oh, Matt, what are you doing? There we go. Wonder what this new power is going to be. Something to do with the dress, won't it? So, all the powers is to do with transforming the dress. So we can glide. It's a double jump and a glide. The lovely pastel painted greens on the squares. Supposed to go? I think so. There we go. Get to that square, can we? Okay, so where we see the red birds, we can do that big spiral jump. We just have to jump at the right point, yeah. I'm shocked at how quick I'm getting some of these things for the puzzles. I'm usually awful at, like, you know, it's like 10 attempts before it clicks. Hmm. Hang on. Oh, you can't get over there. Go again. Not sure where we are now. Oh, yeah, I knew that was a hidden bit. The little, I don't know what instrument it is, like the glockenspiel sounding notes are just giving me such Final Fantasy VIII vibes. The Balam Garden soundtrack, so... Okay... Maybe those pillars aren't in the way, I'm just... No, they're not. Flying. So it's just like a mausoleum of her sadness. I don't know whether the sadness is because she's lost her voice or the sadness caused her to lose her voice. Just go and free the birds. These are the blackbirds. Hello. Let's get out of here. We have an enemy for the first time. It's reminded me of the giant raven from Dark Souls. Oh man, just... Yeah, I am heavy. Leave it out, bird. Okay, that made me jump. What the raven, the bird's significance is. No, we need to use it. Oh, maybe the bird's our friend. He's helping us again here. Okay, I need to slam down with the heavy dress and then do it a jump again. You're gonna leave us alone for a bit now, bird. Palpable silence. Ooh. Let's go. No time to linger. Getting so high up here. So one interesting thing I always remember with colour themes was, I know this is a bit of a tangential reference, but I always remember the Matrix trilogy finding out afterwards that there was a colour theme for each one. So like the original Matrix is, I think that's got more of a green tint, because it's more, it's set in the, because it's more to, more set in the Matrix. Then the Matrix Reloaded has more of a, I can't remember, but it's green, blue and red. They all have apparently a slight colour tint to each one, to represent each world, whether it's the human city, the machine city and the Matrix. Well, you know, psychologically speaking, I suppose, you know, red would traditionally represent anger, blue would traditionally represent maybe calm, sometimes sadness, usually calm and tranquility, and green would represent more growth. Oh, water. Okay, that's cool. I've still got two spirits with me. Hey, radishes! couldn't see any way to get up onto those shapes, so I imagine we just keep going. That was a mistake, wasn't it? Oh, I bet I should have explored that. Felt like it was something we needed to backtrack towards. Oh. Yeah, I missed one, didn't I? Is that just going to spell out her name? That looked like an S. Okay, that was not the right way to go. Go down this way. Anything? Right, so I think I'm going to leave this one here, guys. We'll carry on in the blue part of the world now, next time even. So if you've enjoyed this one, another beautiful setting, some beautiful music where we ran into the blackbird and got rid of him with the bell. If you enjoyed it, maybe leave me a thumbs up on the video. If you want to see more, think about subscribing and join Clan Drummond. Just remember, everyone, never trust. An uncrate. I'll see you next time.